Howdy everybody, it's me, Manic Mark, coming to you from the bunker system located underneath the Art Fellow Found somewhere in the jungles of the Midwest. And I went to Half Price Books today. I've got a few records. And I was trying to think how to do a big wind-up video for the end of the year. And if I do it, it's gonna take some work. And I don't know if I'm going to include it in this video, so that's why I'm just saying it now, in case something happens. I stick it in, because this video will be a little light. If I don't, but it'll be too long if I do. So decisions. What else is going on? The traffic wasn't too bad. I went out and I went to Half Price Books and then Myers. And that was the end. That's all the Christmas shopping. I'm not good with doing stuff like Christmas shopping at all. I don't even know where the hell my Christmas hat is, so I put this on instead. It's somewhat festive. It's the Purple Fairy hat. It's not Purple Fairy. The Purple Fairy's purple. The hat is gold. It's contrasting. The colors. Anyway, go ahead. Okay. We've got the Joy Bill singers. All the Joy Bill, the men, they're all wearing leisure suits. It's the big beat sound of James Last, American Patrol. What the deal is, I find all these weird photographs. I got a million of them to go through, but I'm gonna try to post like a bunch of them from this year's stash of weird, unusual photographs. And it's the ones I was even too. I'm just gonna put the ones that I was too embarrassed to share any other way. Because they're just like, oh my God, you know, I'm just going to put them all in. Just throw it all in and go crazy. That's right. Is Wes Montgomery Greatest Hits? It was Half Price Books Day. And I think I got there just a little bit too late, but not too late. To get the Religious Puppet record, it's Oops, There Comes a Smile. And you know, I've got a million of these, at least two or three copies of this. It's 101 Strings. Wine Paradise, but it's a great, one of their best albums, the 101 Strings albums, but I've never seen it as a gatefold, I was going to say double truck, that's what it is too, that's a double truck one, okay, but, ooh, and there's all the 101s in there that I can look to see whether or not I've got, so I haven't seen that particular Alshire 101 Strings double record, double truck gatefold configuration before, so I picked that up for the collection. It's Rosemary Clooney and the Hi-Lo's Ring Around Rosie. That sounds like something. That's all sticky. I got all the price glue off of that thing there. Now it's dirty. It's dirty and it's crappy. There's a big smeary mark on it. It's Pickwick. Product of Pickwick. It's a sub-label for Pickwick. Quintessential Jazz Series. You gotta be kidding me. This looks good. It's an early, what the hell? Is it Capitol? It's Guitar Music of Spain, but it's Larindo Almedia. He's an excellent guitarist. This is going to be probably pretty straightforward stuff. But he made pop records, too. Later on in his career, but that's very early. Capitol, Full Dimension Sound. Anyway. 1958, it looks like. Take the Message to Mary, Don Cherry. It sort of looks like, yeah, maybe it's a country album, but Misty Blue, Lonely Street, it's not. I really don't have any idea. The Rascals, Once Upon a Dream. Now, this looks pretty kind of like psychedelic-y. I don't know anything about this. Was like getting into the modern, like more popular stuff, but it was just there in the 50 cent bin, so I picked it up. I think I'll like it. This is almost like private, some kind of weird high end private press. I don't know who. What the hell? The Deuce Is Loose. Speaking of psych covers, here's Sergio Mendez Trio, the voice of Wanda D. Shaw. Stan Kent record I have, but this was so clean I picked it up. Because I can't remember whether my copy was nice or not. Lush Interlude Stan Kent. I'm sure I don't have this one, and this is nice except for the seam split. and maybe I'll play that one. I want to play one of these records all the way through with the photographs. Now, Tony Montola, Going Out of My Head, Project 3, this is 1979. This has to be a reissue of his stuff, don't you think? It has to be. I can't believe they were still using the Project 3 label. Somebody was printing Project Diamond Records Limited in 1979. Tony Montola. It's an interesting Andre Previn. You know, I've got a number of his albums. I'm like, you know. But Shelly Mann, Red Mitchell, there's some kind of jazz deal here. Andre Previn and his pals. I don't know. It looks interesting. 1957. That could be interesting. Guitar, woodwinds, and bongos. Alcaola. I don't have this one. I do or don't. I don't know. But that could be interesting. Connie Francis. I picked up Connie Francis. She's covering Baccarat and David. David who? She's a, like, ooh, look, I'm a devil woman. I got the wig on. It's not a wig. Yes, it is a wig. It has to be a wig. And she's got the split in the dress. And she's got the, like, the thing, the look on her face. Like, ooh, look at me. I'm sexy Connie Francis. It's the second Nelson Waikiki album by the ukulele stylist and Kenny Nahaku, Hawaiian Gold. It's an album full of Hawaiian music by the Tennessee Guitars. If you can play a steel guitar, you can do Hawaiian music, so I assume that's what they're up to. I don't know. It's also available at 8-track. It's Ed Kenny's Hawaii. I bought an Ed Kenny album once, and it was not good. He's singing again on this one, and I almost left it, but I noticed that Charles Bud Dant produced the album, so I had to buy it because of Charles Bud Dant's whatever he did on it. I got to figure it out. Wes Montgomery, California Dreamin'. It's a sealed local Blue Wisp. It's a jazz club. I think it's still operating. It's been changed hands a number of times. It's always been operating. I mean, they've moved a few times, two or three times, the club. I'll be trading that one away. I'll probably leave it sealed. They have a house band anyway. That's a record. And last but not least, and I probably couldn't torture you because it's probably going to be a little bit better. I'm thinking because they're out of, it's a private press, and where are they out of? It doesn't say, but the cover is to die for. Sherry Lynn and her chauffeurs, that's the band, that Sherry, they're all wearing the funkadelic suits, but it's not a funk album, unfortunately, it's a private press country album. And I'm just thinking that I couldn't possibly. It's going to have to be instrumental. That's the thing. The photographs are going to have to go with an instrumental thing, which I think I'm probably going to just do independent. And I may not even. I think what I'm going to have to do is put the photographs to avant-garde music. I'm going to pick out one of my avant-garde albums and do that. And that's going to be the big wrap-up this year. Not the two-hour special of me, Manic Mark, clips of me, Manic Mark. Not that. I did that once. And if we could just all communicate with one another and love each other, 2014 is going to be a much, 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 much better. How could it be any worse? It could be a lot worse. And it may be. Apparently, there's some kind of epidemic starting in Texas and there's some other place, there's like the N1H1 virus, it's running rampant, and it's the one they put in even with the shot thing, so I don't know what the hell. I think the apocalypse has started, and it's sweeping the nation. So I got to get the end of the year video done before it's really the end.